Hello students, welcome to the current affair class, and in this class I will be discussing changes in Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Now this topic is important for public administration, sociology and political science optional. Now this topic relates to the changes that has been done Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Now in order to understand the changes, first of all we need to know what originally was this Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, and secondly we need to understand how the scope of the policy has been enhanced, how the scope has increased. First of all, the old policy. Now the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, before we understand this Yojana, it is important to understand the issue of housing in India. India is a country which has a lot of housing deficit. Housing deficit primarily means people don't have access to houses. Now this housing deficit exists not only in the urban areas, but it also exists in the rural areas. In urban areas we have the places, we see many places like in the form of slums. Now why do people live in slums? People live in slums because they don't have access to money, they don't have access to land where they can construct their houses. People don't have access to the finances to construct their houses. And in rural areas, we have instances where people have access to land, but they don't have access to the finance. They don't have access to credit to build their houses. So India, in order to usher in development, in order to provide housing to the people living in the rural landscape and in the urban landscape, it has come out with this policy called Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Now this policy came into being in 2015 and it had a target year of 2022. Now as per this policy, it was envisioned that the urban local bodies will be provided with credit, will be provided with support so that they can provide houses to the people living in the urban areas. So the focus here was only on the urban areas in this policy, and I'm talking about the old policy. And the support that was to be provided to the individual, it was in the form of providing a loan of rupees 6.5 lakh at the interest rate of 6.5%. So this was the amount that was to be given to the rural to the urban population, urban poor population, urban below poverty line population, urban economically weaker sections, urban low income group. So these are the keywords: LIG, low income group, economically weaker section. These are the key word that you should be writing in your mains examination and must also be using while communicating during your interview. So this was the scope of the old policy. Of late, there has been changes proposed in this old policy. Now what are the changes? Like earlier only the urban areas were covered, but now the rural areas will also be covered. Rural areas. Earlier the loan was 6.5 lakh rupees for the urban areas at the interest rate of 6.5%. This has been changed. Now the urban population can avail the loan up to rupees 12 lakh rupees, and this has been divided into two categories. Agar aap 12 lakh rupees ka loan lete ho to us case mein aapko 3% interest subvention milega. Interest subvention. And agar aap loan 9 lakh rupees lete ho us case mein aapko 4% interest subvention milega. So what is meant by interest subvention? Interest subvention is nothing but it is a subsidy that the government will be providing. Agar aapko bank se loan 4% mil raha hai, 4% 9% ke upar mil raha hai, to 3% subvention means that aapko sirf 6% hi uske upar dena hai, baki ka paisa sarkar degi bank ko. So So this is the subsidy that the government will be providing under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. अगर आप अर्बन एरिया में रह रहे हो और आपने 12 लाख रुपए तक का लोन लिया है, आपको 9% से वैसे बैंक से लोन मिल रहा है, तो उस केस में आपको सिर्फ कितने परसेंट इंटरेस्ट पे लोन रीपे करना पड़ेगा? सिर्फ 6% पे. 3% सबवेंशन गवर्नमेंट पे करेगी. अगर आपने 9 लाख रुपए लोन लिया है, इन दैट केस 4% इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन सरकार आपका इंटरेस्ट देगी, रेस्ट यू हैव टू पे. एंड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू the rural area, this is the new category that has been added. अगर आप 2 लाख रुपया लोन लेते हो, 2 लाख, in that case, the government will be providing the interest subvention by 3%. Rural area का नया component है जो इसमें add कर दिया गया. Now when it comes to the eligibility under the new scheme, the government is yet to specify that eligibility criteria. Now the question that can be asked on this very topic, critically analyze the changes that has been done in under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Now the another question could be like, critically analyze India's efforts to meet the sustainable development goals with respect to housing. Critically analyze the policy behind providing housing for all. Now this Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, it came into being in 2015 and the target was to provide housing for all by year 2022. 2022 तक सबको घर देना है, ये फोकस था प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना का. ओल्ड पॉलिसी में चेंजेस क्या आए हैं? अर्बन एरिया को ऐड कर दिया गया है, स्कोप ऑफ जितना क्रेडिट देना है, लोन देना, उसकी लिमिट को बढ़ा दिया गया. रूरल एरियाज को अंदर लेके आए, 3% इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन हो गया. सो दीस चेंजेस हैज बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड आफ्टर डीमोनेटाइजेशन ऑफ इंडियन करेंसी. सो दिस वाज ऑल फॉर द डे. बाय बाय, टेक केयर, हैव अ नाइस डे.